Good afternoon. Thanks for coming on such short notice. On behalf of our owners, Mary Lemieux and Ron Burkle, I'm pleased to announce that the new general manager of the Pittsburgh Penguins is Jim Rutherford. Jim is one of the most respected executives in the National Hockey League. He led the Carolina Hurricanes to the Stanley Cup in 2006 and twice was named NHL Executive of the Year. He also exemplifies class and dignity. When we started identifying candidates for our GM position a few weeks ago, we knew he was someone we needed to talk to. We had the chance to speak with many outstanding hockey people in this process. We had an original list of 30. We talked to 22. We brought 9 into Pittsburgh, and then we brought 4 back as finalists. There were some really good candidates in the mix, but Jim Rutherford, his resume was tough to top. Mary and Ron got together and discussed it this week and determined that Jim was the man for the job, and we're very lucky that he said yes. This certainly isn't a rebuild. We haven't had the success we've wanted in the playoffs over the past 5 seasons, but this is a very good team with star players, and a good organization, and lots of important pieces in place. It became clear to ownership that Jim's experience and reputation as a strong and steady leader made him the clear choice for what we have to accomplish. His vision for the Penguins in both the near future and moving forward was something that very much impressed us. He flew into Pittsburgh yesterday, met with Mario and our executive team, signed his contract, and now he's ready to go. With that, I'd like to introduce to you the new general manager of the Pittsburgh Penguins, Jim Rutherford.
Thank you. Thank you, David. Thank you to Mario Lemieux and Ron Burkle for giving me this opportunity. I'm very excited about it. It's a great opportunity. Excited about working with Sidney Crosby and Geno Malkin and all the talented players that are around the Pittsburgh Penguins organization. This is a job that most GMs would like to have, and I was very lucky and very fortunate at this point in my career that I've been given this opportunity. Before I go on, I do want to thank Peter Kermanis, who is the owner of the Carolina Hurricanes, a very close friend of mine, and he was just a great boss to me for 30 years, almost 31 years. For anybody that's wondering about whether I'm thinking about staying 31 years in Pittsburgh, probably not, but 31 years was a long run with one person, certainly in professional sports. And I'd also like to thank Ronnie Francis, who's become a close friend of mine, and the new general manager of the Hurricanes, and I know he's going to do a terrific job there. On Saturday, this all happened very quickly. On Saturday of last week, I came in to meet with Mario and Ron and David, and that whole thing transpired really in a matter of a couple of days. I got a phone call. I was sitting on my back porch, I think it was on Thursday, from David, wondering what I was doing, what my real position was with the Hurricanes, and whether I would consider coming and running another NHL team. And obviously the fact that it was the Pittsburgh Penguins, it didn't take me long to say yes, and that he had to get permission to from my owner. So he did. He came in on Saturday. We had the opportunity to discuss a lot of things. It was a great meeting. We exchanged ideas. Really, more importantly for me, was what was going on here and what ideas are coming from ownership. And so giving that some thought, and I left on Saturday, and they said that they'd be back to me, and I got a call on Thursday afternoon, about 5 minutes after I walked out of the dermatologist. As you can see, I've been beat up by the dermatologist a little bit here, so it's like the way life goes, the timing is always not ideal, but wondered if I could come in the next day and get more serious about this discussion. And so I did, and here we are today. But with the information that I took from ownership and with the understanding of what has taken place here, we determined that it was time to go in a different direction with the coach also. And what the ownership wants here is a complete change in direction, one with the general manager and one with the coach. So we met with Dan this morning and told him, and the timing of it is good because he's a good man and a good coach. I really don't know him very well, and I only talked to him just briefly this morning. But the timing is good because there's coaching vacancies, and it's not going to be long until he coaches again in the league. Going forward, I'm looking forward to restructuring the organization a little bit. I think there's a lot of good people here, and I think there's a few guys that aren't far away from being general managers in this league. And so I'm going to appoint Jason Botterill to be my associate general manager. He will work very close with me on all matters, and his input is going to be taken very seriously. Also, I want to promote Bill Guerin and Tom Fitzgerald to be assistant general managers. Billy plays a very key role, as I understand some of the things now that are going on. I don't understand everything. I don't understand it completely. I really have to get around the players and get training camp going and get into the season a little bit. But Billy's wasn't long ago since he's a player. He understands what makes these players tick. And he's going to be my day-to-day guy that really communicates with the players, and he's around the players a lot more in the room to understand if we have an issue on a certain time or if everything's going fine, because when there's issues, I like to get on top of it and deal with it directly myself. I'm also going to bring analytics into the organization. I don't think that we're up to speed here on the use of analytics. And this is something that I've gotten used to over the last few years. The analytics, if used properly, are great to really check everybody's opinion. I'm not going to make my final decision like they do in baseball just based on analytics. I'm going to make a gut decision when it comes time to calling players up or making player trades. But I do think that this is something that we have to get up to speed on, and I am going to add somebody into the organization in the next few weeks to put this together for us. I'm very grateful for this opportunity. It's really a dream job for most general managers, and I have had a very blessed hockey career. I played for a long time in the league. I was fortunate to play as a Penguin, and I've had a long run as a general manager, and I know that my experience in dealing with things will be able to help this organization get to our ultimate goal. I don't think we have all the pieces here to get back to where the Penguins were in 09, but with some changes, they don't have to be sweeping changes. We can do this in the very near future. So, open up for questions.
Jim, Rob Rossi, Pittsburgh Tribune Review. Your team's missed the playoffs the last 5 years in Carolina. What do you think the reasons were for that? What do you bring with that experience to trying to get this team over the hump of qualifying not being good enough for ownership? And also, you mentioned complete change in direction with the GM and coach. You've also promoted three people that were part of Ray Shiro's inner circle to new positions. Why that decision if they want complete change?
Yeah. Well, when I say complete change, it's really the main decision makers, okay? And as you saw, I didn't address the assistant coaching staff. But one thing that I have done with them is given them permission to talk to other teams if they wish. But if they wish to not move on immediately until a head coach is announced, they're more than welcome to do that. And the head coach is going to make that decision who his assistants are. As for the Hurricanes missing over the last 5 years, I have reasons and I know what they were. Certainly our goaltending issue with injuries over the last couple of years have been a key. For the most part, we played right down to the stretch, right down to the last game in some seasons as far as not making it. So we've had competitive teams there. But clearly the business model between the Carolina Hurricanes and the Pittsburgh Penguins is different. Okay, and you've been around long enough, you can figure out what I'm saying. So, but I have nothing but respect for the Hurricanes and the growth of hockey in Carolina, and I think they're on the right track. So, but for me to start picking out different players and whatnot doesn't make sense at this point.
Jim, first on the head coaching hire, whenever that is made, what type of candidate do you tend to look for, type of coach, style of play, those sorts of things? And David, I'm not sure if we're able to ask you at this point or not too, but I know you explained the thought process with keeping Dan at the time. Do you regret kind of the way that played out at this point, since it happened so quickly now after the hiring?
We talked about that when we talked about Ray. We wanted to systematically look at the whole organization from top to bottom. We didn't want to make hasty decisions. We went through a process over the course of 3 weeks, and we came to a conclusion. I don't regret anything. I think we actually had a very thorough process. As I said before, we talked to over 22 people. We looked at 30 different resumes. We talked to people about people. We talked to people internally about what was going on within the organization. We talked to people about what they thought needed to happen to make the organization better. And I think through that process is how we got to where we are today. And I think it's a good place where we are today.
Okay, I forgot your question. No, I didn't. I have a short list of coaches in mind, okay? The coach is going to have to adjust to the style of players that we have, because with the talent level of the Penguins can play whatever way you want, okay? But certainly with the teams that we ultimately have to compete with, we're going to have a coach that can make the proper adjustments during a game or during a certain period of time in the regular season or during a playoff series. And obviously the Penguins can score and they can go and they can score in bunches, but based on looking at the Penguins from a distance, because that's where I was, I don't think that they could make the proper adjustments against certain teams. And so that's going to be a key factor when I'm looking at a head coach. And then it's going to be important to the chemistry of the head coach. If the head coach is a certain way, we may need a X and O's guy as a head coach and a motivator as an assistant coach or vice versa, but we have to get a good mix of guys.
Jim, over here.